This is one of Beethoven's string quartets. Maybe you have listened to it before. And in our lab, we wanted to know, why does Beethoven sound like Beethoven? We decoded Beethoven's composition style from a harmonic perspective. We used statistics to analyze all of his 16 string quartets, which is roughly about 8 hours of music. We looked at all the scores of the string quartets and analyzed each chord. So we put a symbol on top of each chord in the scores, and then we counted how often all of these chords appear. And this makes up almost 30,000 chords. And among these 30,000, we have about 1,000 different chords. Very often, music theory does not describe how things are, but says how things should be. It will probably tell you that in classical music, 2 chords are very common. That is a dominant chord and a tonic chord. For instance, in this string quartet, we find a lot of transitions from the dominant to the tonic. We have here a dominant, here a tonic, here a dominant, here a tonic again, and this sounds like this. So we found that indeed dominant chords and tonic chords are very, very common in this data set. We also found that very few chords make up the largest portion of the data, and we found importantly that the order in which the chords appears matters a lot, so you cannot play the music backwards in a certain sense. Well, we do this to understand how composers write music. Of course, there are a lot of differences between composers, but actually, if you zoom out a little bit, you see also a lot of commonalities. I'm a pianist. I like music. I like to play music. But I also like to understand why I like certain things. I would like to expand this also to like 19th century composers like Chopin, Liszt, building up the whole picture of music, if you want. And also to include other dimensions. We want to look at rhythm, at the meter, and at the instrumentation.